Did you know the real destination of the legendary journey to the West wasn't a mythic land, but Nalanda University in India, a real place that was later burned to the ground? Chinese fantasy literature is rare, yet Journey to the West exploded into a masterpiece that reshaped imagination across Asia. But here's the hidden story behind it. Across history, four of humanity's greatest knowledge centers, including Nalanda, were completely destroyed. What if none of them had fallen? What if their knowledge had survived, evolved, and merged into a parallel universe overflowing with exotic creatures, lost sciences, and global scholars learning side by side? Stay to the end of this video, where AI will reveal the world we should have inherited, if civilization's brightest flames were never extinguished. Across ancient history, four great centers of knowledge burned. The Library of Alexandria, where the wisdom of Greece, Egypt, and Rome vanished into smoke. Baghdad's House of Wisdom, heart of the Islamic Golden Age, drowned in ink and fire in 1258. China's Shaolin Temple, destroyed again and again, losing scrolls of philosophy and martial tradition. And Nalanda, India's crown jewel of learning, a university that once held the world's largest collection of human knowledge. Founded in the 5th century, Nalanda was no ordinary school. It was the world's first true residential university, with 10,000 students and 2,000 teachers. Scholars arrived from China, Korea, Tibet, Sri Lanka, Persia, and Southeast Asia to study astronomy, medicine, mathematics, logic, linguistics, and the biological sciences of the time. Nalanda's libraries were legendary. 9 million manuscripts stored in multi-story towers known as the treasuries of knowledge. Here, Indian mathematicians refined the decimal system, astronomers calculated planetary motion, and physicians documented surgical techniques centuries before Europe rediscovered them. But in 1193, Nalanda burned for months. Its libraries collapsed into ash, its scholars scattered, and with its fall, a scientific civilization that connected Asia quietly ended. India lost not just a university, but the momentum to lead global scientific discovery. But imagine, if Nalanda had survived, if its manuscripts, teachers, and scientific culture had continued unbroken for 800 more years. In this parallel world, India becomes the first center of modern science. Nalanda grows into a vast biological research city, preserving species and reviving those long extinct, dodos returning beneath mango trees, mammoths walking the plains, saber-tooth tigers resting beside scholars. A Tang dynasty monk studies side by side with Indian teachers, guarded by a monkey warrior and a loyal pig companion, exchanging knowledge across civilizations. Here, Asia advances centuries early. Medicine flourishes, astronomy leaps forward, and the secrets of life are unlocked in ancient courts bathed in sunlight. A world where Nalanda never fell, and where the birthplace of modern science stands not in the West, but in India.
Long ago, the pages shimmered under India's rising sun. Scholars drew the stars in silence, mapping worlds we'd yet to run. But the winds of war came turning, and the night swallowed the day. A thousand dreams burned into ash, a universe slipped away. Would India lead the light? What if Nalanda never fell? What if knowledge never burned at all? Would the engines of discovery have risen from those ancient halls? Would the world have looked to India for the way the future's told? What if the torch that vanished then had lit the modern world with gold? Ooh. The wisdom that might have been, imagine if the scrolls kept growing. Woolly mammoths roaming free, healers learning life's own rhythm. From the roots beneath the banyan tree, picture continents connected by a science drawn in Sanskrit lines. India guiding generations, centuries ahead of time. What if Nalanda never fell? What if knowledge never burned? the torch that vanished then had lit the modern world with cold. Ooh. A future that time forgot. Maybe medicine would bloom like forests. Maybe stars would speak their names. Maybe life itself rewritten would echo through forgotten plains. Maybe children everywhere would learn the sky from ancient lore of a land where wisdom blossomed and lost dreams still soar.
If Nalanda stood today, what if Nalanda never fell? What if flames had never touched its walls? Would our world be shaped by India and the science of her ancient call? What if we could turn the pages of a story history never told? Would we find future in the ashes of the old? Ooh. Soft whisper. What if the dawn we lost back then was the sunrise meant for all?